The surname Rizal was suggested by a provincial governor who was a family friend of the Mercado. And this was used by Jose Rizal when he enrolled in Ateneo because his brother, who was associated with Father Jose Burgos, was hunted by authorities for his link with one of the martyred priests. So he hid himself from the family of the Mercado and used the family name Rizal. The family name Rizal means green fields. Jose Rizal was born on June 19, 1861 in Calamba, Laguna. He was the seventh child of Don Francisco and Doña Chodora.
A phenom is someone who is exceptionally talented or admired, especially an up-and-comer. Jose, during his childhood, was none less than a phenom. Jose Rizal's first memory in his infancy was his happy days in their family garden when he was 3 years old. Their courtyard contained tropical fruit trees, poultry yard, a carriage house, and a stable for the ponies. Because the young Pepe was weak, sickly, and undersized, he was given the fondest care by his parents, so his father built a nipa cottage for Pepe to play in the daytime. Memory of his infancy included the nocturnal walk in the town, especially when there was a moon. Jose also recalled the Aya, relating to the Rizal children some fabulous stories like those about the fairies, tales of buried treasure, and trees blooming with diamonds. Another childhood memory was the daily Angelus prayer. Rizal recorded in his memoir that by nightfall, his mother would gather all the children in their home to pray the Angelus. At the early age of 3, he started to take a part in the family prayers. When Concha died of sickness in 1865, Jose mournfully wept at losing her. He later wrote in his memoir, "When I was 4 years old, I lost my little sister Concha, and then for the first time, I shed tears caused by love and grief." At the age of 5, the young Pepe learned to read the Spanish family Bible, which he would refer to later in his writings. Rizal himself remarked that perhaps the education he received since his earliest infancy was that had shaped his habits. As a child, Rizal loved to go to the chapel, pray, participate in novenas, and join religious processions. In Calamba, one of the men he esteemed and respected was a scholarly Catholic priest, Leoncio Lopez, the town priest. He used to visit him and listen to his inspiring opinions on current events and thorough life views. Also, at the age of 5, Pepe started to make pencil sketches and mold in clay and wax objects, which attracted his fancy. When he was about 6 years old, his sisters once laughed at him for spending much time making clay and wax images. Initially keeping silent, he then prophetically told them, "All right, laugh at me now. Someday when I die, people will make monuments and images of me." When Jose was 7 years old, his father provided him the exciting experience of riding a casco, or a flat-bottomed boat with a roof, on their way to a pilgrimage in Antipolo. As a gift, the child Jose received a pony named Alipato from his father. As a child, he loved to ride this pony or take long walks in the meadows and lakeshore with his black dog named Usman. Before he was 8 years old, he had written a drama which was performed at a local festival and for which the municipal captain rewarded him with 2 pesos. Some other influences of Rizal's childhood involved his 3 uncles, his tio Jose Alberto, who inspired him to cultivate his artistic ability, his tio Manuel, who encouraged him to fortify his frail body through physical exercises, and his tio Gregorio, who intensified Rizal's avidness to read good books. Let's proceed to one of the most influential stories in Jose Rizal's life, the story of the moth. To impart essential life lessons, Doña Lolay held regular storytelling sessions with the young Rizal. Doña Teodora loved to read to Pepe stories from the book Amigo de los Niños. To teach the value of obedience to one's parents, she afterward read him a story. Lolay chose the story about a daughter moth who was warned by her mother against going too near a lamp flame. Though the young moth promised to comply, she later succumbed to the pull of the light's mysterious charm, believing that nothing bad would happen if she approached it with caution. The moth then flew close to the flame. Feeling comforting warmth at first, she drew closer and closer, bit by bit, until she flew too close enough to the flame and perished. Incidentally, Pepe was watching a similar incident while he was listening to the storytelling. Like a live enactment, a moth was fluttering too near to the flame of the oil lamp on their table. Not merely acting out, it did fall dead as a consequence. Both moths in the two tales paid the price of getting near the fatal light. Many years later, Rizal himself felt that the moth's tail could serve as an allegory of his own destiny. About himself, he wrote, "Years have passed since then. The child has become a man. Steamships have taken him across seas and oceans. He has received from experience bitter lessons, much more bitter than the sweet lessons that his mother gave him. Nevertheless, he has preserved the heart of a child. He still thinks that light is the most beautiful thing in creation, and that it is worthwhile for a man to sacrifice his life for it."
Rizal had his early education in Calambaan, Binyan, and it was a typical education for a son of an Ilustrado family. He received lessons in reading, writing, arithmetic, and religion. As mentioned, Doña Teodora was Rizal's first teacher at their home in Calamba, Laguna. As Rizal's teacher, Doña Teodora was very patient, conscientious, and understanding. It was also during their lessons together that Doña Teodora noticed Rizal's talent when it comes to poetry. So, she encouraged him to continue writing poems. Also, Doña Teodora kept on telling stories to young Rizal to stimulate his imagination. As Jose grew older though, his parents decided to hire private tutors to teach him at their home. The first was Maestro Celestino. The second was Maestro Lucas Padua. And then the last one, it was Leon Monroy, who happens to be a former classmate of Rizal's father. But when old Monroy died, his parents decided to send him to a formal school in Binyan, Laguna. Rizal then went on to attend an all-boys private school in Binyan, Laguna from 1870 to 1871 under Maestro Justiniano Aquino Cruz. The maestro's Nipa hut served as the school, wherein Rizal mastered both Spanish and Latin subjects. Rizal was very excellent in all of his subjects. He excelled in each one, especially Latin and Spanish, where he bested all of his classmates. Young Rizal was also very interested in art, which made him a frequent visitor of the painter Juancho. Juancho was so impressed with Rizal's artistry that he gave him free lessons in drawing and painting, where Rizal excelled very well.